of change, and we have not lost track of that. So what Mr. President presented and the priorities therein are still sustained and in some extent enhanced, but nothing that different at all.
Thank you very much, sir. You've heard it from the horse's mouth. The Senate has received the budget that has been laid and is going to pass and transmit to the executive on tomorrow, Wednesday. That's your summary of what transpired today at the plenary. Thank you, and over to you in the studio.
Thank you, Muhammad Ali. And meanwhile, the deputy Senate leader, Bala Ibinala, says the only way to turn around the Nigerian economy is by broadening the base of the participation in governance and business activities. This was at the closing session of the National Assembly's Business Environment Roundtable in Abuja. National Assembly correspondent Ifeanyi Zumba reports.
Other recommendations are that the Federal Ministry of Works be charged with spearheading implementations of sectoral policies, while the National Transport Commission be charged with regulations. The breakout group also called for government not to establish, own and operate a bank. Rather, incentives should be provided for private sector involvement.
They recommend the simplification of tax laws, the reduction in the number of taxes, and they want to reinforce accountability and transparency of the tax process.
In the winding statement, the deputy Senate leader stressed that the National Assembly will constitute an ad hoc committee to pursue the recommendations.
Businesses do not thrive under bureaucracy. When you remove government participation in determining how businesses should go in the country, the better for the society.
Some participants had contributed this way.
There's really not much said about marine transportation.
We see adequate representation for young persons in this sort of environment. They have a key role, they have recommendations.
It will assist the Senate to really look at issues that are germane, various industries.
To have inputs from the private sector, from the public sector.
The aim of the forum is to look at ways the 8th Assembly can unbundle the Nigerian business system by removing monopoly. From the National Assembly, Ifeanyi Izumba, NT News.
And good news coming in, Information and Culture Minister Lai Mohammed has begun talks with the Qatar-based international media network Al Jazeera on a possible partnership for capacity building. This was the outcome of the minister's visit to the Training and Development Center of the Media Network in Doha, Qatar. Anthony Forsin has more.
This is the Al Jazeera Training and Development Center. It was established in 2004 with a focus to provide quality manpower in media-related fields. And so, when Nigeria's Information and Culture Minister, Lai Mohammed, came visiting, the management wasted no time in letting him know that his choice to visit the center is apt, given the prominence it enjoys in the media world. The director of the center, Monir Demi, said this is because Al Jazeera keeps pace with the latest technology that drives the media industry. Then, Information and Culture Minister Lai Mohammed opened his mission.
I have inherited a very big behemoth, you know, television authority in Nigeria. But I don't think I'm happy with exactly what we have today. And once you lose credibility in this business, you also lose profitability. Because you lose viewership and you're also going to lose advertisers. Today, we are just struggling to rebuild the image, credibility of the National Television Authority, which we call the NTA. NTA is, I think, today is the only organization in Nigeria that can be reached, can be viewed all over Nigeria. But it's, over the years, neglected a lot of things, infrastructure, training, programming. And that's why I believe that this rapport with Al Jazeera is going to be mutually beneficial to both parties.
The Al Jazeera management team wasted no time in embracing the minister's request.
We can help in that sense, and as you mentioned, Your Excellency, is that this probably needs long meetings and more of a customized solution rather than off-the-shelf solution that comes for everybody. So what we need to do is probably have more meetings and more extended meetings with people, relevant people from different sides. And then we can take it from there, so we can discuss what the needs are.
With an extensive network strategically located within today's media world, Al Jazeera says it is open to partnership and exchanges as it provides training in television, radio, print, and all media-related management operations. From Doha, Qatar, Anthony Forson, NTA News.
I'm back in Nigeria House Committee on Maritime Safety, Education and Administration has challenged the Maritime Academy of Nigeria Round to develop a template to enhance development and standards in the institution. The committee was on an oversight function there. Let's join Clement Baruku.
The Maritime Academy of Nigeria was established as an institution that will train manpower for the effective and efficient operation of the maritime sector. The House Committee said they were on a fact-finding mission of the institution because of the strategic importance of the maritime sector in the economy of the nation. The committee reiterated the commitment of the National Assembly to the overall development of the institution and mandated the authority of the Maritime Academy to articulate their needs and challenges.
There has not been any deliberate policy to make sure that these cadets graduate from one level to the next level. The law that established this academy alone has given you all the rights and powers to go on and make sure they move.
The registrar of the academy, Mr. Nkpandiok Nkpandiok, briefed the House Committee on the contribution of the institution to the national economy and expressed optimism that with adequate facilities, the institution will develop the manpower requirements of the maritime sector.
Being a development environmental process, we still have a lot of needs to be able to stand and be counted among committee of maritime academies in the world.
The visit of the committee is part of their oversight function, while a minute silence was observed in honor of the rector of the institution, Dr. Joshua Okpo, who died last year. In Oron, Clement Barikui, NTA News.
We are not done with maritime issues, as the maritime security experts also say collaboration between countries and the Gulf of Guinea is key to securing the waterways. This form part of submissions by guests on NTA's Good Morning Nigeria by taking a look at ways of enhancing maritime security in the region. Amina Najim has details.
Nigeria's maritime industry has come under severe threat in recent times. This has resulted in a loss of over 400 million naira between February 2010 and February 2011 to the activities of sea robbers, according to NEMASA. A scenario the guest described as worrisome.
Oil is the jugular of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. So when you attack export loading platform, both oil and gas, you can be sure that the repercussions are immediate. A drop in exports to affect other things.
Our government needs to say something about economic and national saboteurs. That will empower the Navy, that will empower NEMASA, that will empower even, or rather encourage our ECOWAS brothers.
To tackle this challenge head-on, collaboration between neighboring countries in the sub-region, the maritime experts insist, is key, as no country has the technical know-how to handle the challenge on its own.
There is what we call hot pursuits. If you are pursuing a criminal and you get to the boundary of your own nation, you must stop pursuing that criminal because you will be committing another crime by entering other people's water.
We are having these challenges in the sense that every organization that is responsible for this same purpose are having disjointed in that respect. And therefore, there's a need to have a handshake with all the facilities so that we achieve the same purpose.
Right after the summit of the heads of states and government of Central and West Africa, which you may be aware of, that took place in June 2013, there was a decision for all countries, not just in West Africa, but in Central Africa, to fight the scourge of illicit maritime activities at sea. So if the resources from these countries come from sea, then Obviously, they must put up a collective fight.
In all, the guests say there is need for increased political will on the part of governments in the region to ensure proper policing of the Gulf of Guinea. Amina Nujaim, NTA News.
Tompolo in court as fire raises shanties in Lekki. There's a more from our Lagos Network Center with Ademola as our guide. Ademola, it's good to see you.
Good to see you too, Femi, and welcome to Lagos. Following the inability of the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, to compel the attendance of former Niger Delta militant leader, Government Ekpemokpolo, also known as Tompolo, to appear in court, former Director General of NIMASA, Patrick Akpobolokeme, has been arraigned by the EFCC alongside eight others over 35 billion naira fraud. Viera Chimoba, who was at the Federal High Court, reports that the charge was separated to enable EFCC prosecute other accused persons. Meanwhile, Tompolo is on the run.
The arraignment had continuously been stalled due to the inability of EFCC to arrest Tompolo, who has been on the run. Tompolo will now face a separate charge when arrested. The former NIMASA Director General Patrick Akpobolokeme, Ken Engozuan, a Gagrin born a captain wearing the Anisero, and five companies were accused of conspiracy to commit fraud between 2012 and 2015. They were arraigned on a 40-count charge. When the charges were read and plea taken, they pleaded not guilty. The defendant lawyers prayed the court to grant their client's bail. However, the prosecution counsel, Festus Keyamo, did not oppose the bail application because the accused persons are already on bail in another charge before the court. Justice Ibrahim Buba granted the bail in the sum of 50 million naira with one surety in like sum. Captain Eniswa, who was charged with two out of a 40-count charge, received a 10 million naira bail with one surety in like sum. Justice Buba, however, asked the accused persons to perfect their bail terms or be remanded in prison custody. Further hearing continues on the 23rd of May in Lagos. Viera Chumuba, NTA News.
Two people were killed and several properties destroyed when fire outbreak occurred in the early hours of yesterday at some shanties located in Jakande Estate, Lekki, Lagos. Ken Egbeluhe has details.
The fire, which gutted the makeshift structures constructed with woods, started in the early hours of Monday. According to eyewitnesses, the fire started in one of the shops on the road and spread to other areas. It took the help of Lagos State Fire Service to contain further spread of the fire.
We see that one cabin already catched fire. Before you know it, the second one have catched the fire. It spread all the cabin here, as you can see. Even two people dead. Husband and wife sleeping in the cabin, two of them hold themselves, then burned to ashes.
Although the cause of the fire which killed two people is yet to be ascertained, some concerned residents in the area say there is an urgent need for government to pay serious attention to the area.
They should do something about it. They should just cancel anything about this kind of environment here.
Several complaints have gone from the neighborhood to the local government and to the governor. And we have been given assurances that they are taking care of it.
The residents of these shanties are made up of people who previously operated at Kuramo Beach. They migrated to Lekki and occupied an expanse of land beside Jakande low-cost housing estate located at Beach Gate Road in Lagos. Ken Egbeluge, NTA News.
Nigerians have been urged to respect, protect and promote the rights of all persons with disabilities, including those with Down syndrome. Speakers at an event to mark this year's Down Syndrome Day say people with disability deserve special attention from government. The event was organized by the Down Syndrome Foundation of Nigeria in collaboration with the United Nations Information Center. Rotimi Oluwagbemi reports.
That performance by children from Down Syndrome Foundation set the tone for the event. With the theme, My Friends, My Community, the United Nations Secretary General, who was represented by the Director, United Nations Information Center, Lagos, enjoined everyone to appreciate the potential and power of persons with Down syndrome. He also called for priority actions to improve opportunities for girls and women with disabilities in the society.
On this World Down Syndrome Day, let us resolve to support the autonomy and independence of persons with Down syndrome.
the Lagos State Commissioner for Information and Strategy, Steve Ayoride, who was represented, said the state government is resolute towards its commitment to improve the quality of life of persons with Down syndrome.
Risks have been managed in most of the buildings to make the environment friendly. There had been so many of these disabled people that are in the employment of the state government.
The national president of Down Syndrome Foundation appealed to Nigerians to extend their hands of fellowship to those with Down syndrome instead of stigmatizing them.
You can't wish these children away. They are there in our society. Therefore, we need to bring any case concerning them to the front burner.
Early intervention is what, you know, helps parents to support their children.
Highlight of the event was the exhibition of some artworks and other food items produced by the people with Down syndrome. In Lagos, Rotimi Oluwagbemi, NTA News.
In line with the federal government's efforts to sustain reformatory initiatives that will transform the lives of its inmates ahead of their release from prisons, an educational intervention laboratory was inaugurated at the maximum prisons in Kirikiri, Lagos. Musatolia reports that the reformatory gesture was carried out by a non-governmental organization.
Organizers of the event say the gesture is born out of the popular saying that an educated person is one who has learned and is empowered to effect positive change in the society. They explain that the move is aimed at providing prison inmates with learning tools and resources, especially those who are preparing for external examinations at the prison's National Open University Education Center. Non-academic books and magazines were part of the provisions made available to cater to the needs of those who are not academically inclined.
If we provide books and enlightenment for the prisoners, we protect the society. They come out better people, we have less crimes, and they will be better human beings.
The Comptroller General of Prisons, Peter Ekpendu, who was represented at the event, lauded the library initiative.
We have some of our inmates sitting for the WAEC and the NECO examinations. The donation of library to the inmates will go a long way in the reformation program.
He said the project will enhance inmates' academic pursuits and make them productive after securing their freedom from the prisons. Zacchaeus Onumba Dibezue Memorial Libraries have been established in Ekoyi Prison, Bidom Security Prison, Kirikiri, and Badagry Prison. In Lagos, Musa Tolian, NTA News.
Well, that does it from Lagos. It's back to you, Femi, for more on Nationwide. Good afternoon.
Thank you, Ademola. To ease accommodation problems and the police and also check corruption within the force, Inspector General of Police Solomon Araza has balloted for the first time ever 400 units of bungalows to inspectors and other ranks in the police. Bonaventure Nwodo has more.
Inspector General of Police said the quick completion of the houses is to keep to his promise.
This is premised on our fervent belief that the desire to own a home is paramount in the heart of every police personnel, and the urge to fulfill this natural necessity remains at the heart of corruption in the force.
He explained that the housing scheme is being done in all states of the Federation, including Federal Capital Abuja. The IGP said every personnel of the force will be entitled to own a house, but 20% of the houses can be allowed to the public as part of consolidating the community policing component. The first batch of the houses allocated were conducted through ballot system to ensure transparency.
Corporal Uchenna Ono, good morning. Congratulations, you are a proud owner of
They are located in Yola, Benin, Katsina, and Enugu states. IGP Solomon Arase thanked the police management for allowing the scheme to be a reality. In Abuja, Bonaventure Wood, NTA News.
Meanwhile, as part of his duties to also ensure a peaceful and orderly society, police have taken the campaign on no crime, no drug, and no cultism to schools, as well as reaching out to students on what the Nigerian police stands for. Edino Justice reports.
This week is usually celebrated to showcase the Nigerian police, who they are, what they do, and how they want the public to perceive them.
to get these messages across. They went around some schools within Abuja Metropolis, where they introduced members of various professions like medical doctors, engineers, pilots, educationists, lawyers, and many more that work as policemen and women. The police professional talk on drug abuse, cultism, its effects, and the need to avoid them.
What's the effect of the drug and its force, so you can make more problems in your school wall, problems with the teachers?
Some of the students and the officials speak.
I learned that police are nice. Before, I hate police like my enemy.
They have given us the idea that they are our friends and we can trust them.
Yeah, I think they are much more effective for us because they have experts in different fields.
The police is a total human being. That's how I now perceive the Nigerian police.
The first education officer, Deputy Commissioner of Police Ibrahim Kabiru, says the essence is to change the perception of the Nigerian police force.
Police is not only about arrest and prosecution, but that in police you have almost every profession, whatever your dream is in life, you can actualize it in the police.
In Abuja, Evening of Justice, NTA News.
And still on the police, your state police command arraigns couple over false information. What is that information? Let's join Dauju from Ibadan Network Center.
Hello, Femi. Good to see you. Good afternoon and welcome to Ibadan. Osun State government has flagged off another round of deworming of children in elementary schools. State Deputy Governor Titi Laoye Tomori said the initiative is aimed at getting the best out of the state's school feeding program. Adeniyi Taiwo has the report.
Flagging off the statewide exercise, Osun State Deputy Governor Chief Titi Laoye Tomori said the program will cover about 300,000 school children who are also direct beneficiaries of the state school meal programs. Worm infestations, according to her, is one health challenge confronting good nutrition and proper growth among school children, which the state government hopes to ward off through well-coordinated mass deworming in schools.
School-based deworming has led to higher record of school attendance by pupils in the participating schools. Our administration must continue to deworm the kids to forestall the forbidding effects of worm infestation in pupils in our public elementary schools.
In his remark at the ceremony, the Permanent Secretary, Minister of Health, Dr. Akin Kaisho, observed that worm infestation, which often occurred through consumption of badly cooked meals, walking barefooted, and poor hygiene, can hinder proper learning among school children. For the pupils, there was no better way to show their gratitude to the state government than through this cultural presentation where they showered praises on the governor and his team. The mass deworming exercise takes place twice in a year in the state, in Oshobo. Adeniyi Taiwo.
In order to curtail the menace of ethnic competition and rivalry in Nigeria, traditional rulers have an urge to serve as formidable barricade that will ensure peace and security of the nation. Lanre Gbele has details.
The result of this various ethnic competition and rivalry was the incessant mayhem which has left scars visible and invisible in various communities where the streets had a desolate look as businesses closed down and people fled the town in panic. This incessant conflict, according to Archbishop Ayo Ladigbolu, could be curtailed if traditional rulers in their various communities could create a platform for dialogue irrespective of social, political, religious, and ethnic affiliations.
To advise all the traditional rulers to see it as one of their paramount responsibilities, the bonding of the ethnic nationalities.
Institution right now.
They are giving them 7 days to prosecute this company for corporate manslaughter.
Must students who are future leaders of the nation be destructive?
They think the management and the government will listen to them very well if they destroy school property.
There is another day that says that if a provoked houseboy cannot match his master strength to strength, he maims his master's most favorite good. That is the principle I know. Students apply, but unfortunately, it is a bad principle.
Sociologists believe that proper orientation and attitudinal change are solutions to this practice.
Oh, most of what students protest about is increments, something that affects their welfare. And so it is important for us to carry students along when we are making policies that would affect their life. And so this is what happens in most of the cases where you see students taking to the streets. And it does not turn violent, except you have a counter effort to check them from expressing themselves.
Observers, however, see a future peaceful society where integrity shapes the behavior and actions of each individual. In Ibadan, Femi Afolabi, NTA News.
And that's our contribution from Ibadan. It's back to you, Femi, in Abuja for continuation of Nationwide. Good afternoon.
Thank you, Daljo. Meanwhile, the federal government's strikes against Boko Haram terrorists in the northeast has been described as a true reflection of the Muhammadu Buhari's administration's dogged commitment in crushing insurgency light from taking off. Emir of Damaturu Shehu Hashim II Ibn Kanemi said this when he received the Buhari Friends Organization Network. Abubakar Galadima Shuaibu has more.
Led by its national patron, Elder Bala Mamman Ingawa, the team was recently at the palace of Emir of Damaturu in Yobe State, seeking to collaborate with the royal father in educating his subjects to realize that the present economic situation is a global issue that needs to be addressed by all.
This government is not an ignorant government. When you cry, to listen. But only our people is too impatient.
On his part, the Emir of Damaturu, Alhaji Shehu Hashimi II, Ibn El-Kanemi, assured the Buhari Friends Organization Network of resolve to partner with them in sensitizing his subject and, by extension, the general public on the policies and programs of President Muhammadu Buhari-led administration.
We are able to enlighten our subjects to be law-abiding. We've been providing useful information to the security.
Leader of the delegation presented appointment letter as royal patron to the Emir for his effort towards sustenance of peace in the states. In Damaturu, Abubakar Galadima Shuaibu, NTA News.
The federal government has been urged to fulfill all the existing commitments on improving child and maternal health in Nigeria. This was the position of the Federation of Muslim Women Association of Nigeria, Form 1, at a training of trainings on advocacy and communication strategy, which was held in Abuja. Fatima Liu has more.
World Health Organization rated Nigeria as the second largest contributor to under 5 and maternal mortality in the world. Analysis of recent...
Don't go away.
If you hear a bomb explosion or gunshots of an active shooter, that might be a terror attack. At such times, always remember three action words. Run, hide, report. Don't try to run towards the terror scene to save the situation, because there might be a second bomb blast or another attack. Run far away and take cover. Make sure you are safe first. Yes, it is in our nature to sympathize over the hurt, but remember, only trained personnel can help in such situations. When in a secured environment, promptly call relevant authorities and help will come. For anonymous reporting, call 09630-32505 or 0813-2222-106. If you see something, say something. Nigeria, unite against terrorism. This message is brought to you by the Federal Ministry of Information and Culture.
This week on Airtel Touching Lives, we visit Folusha Pamilerin, who was crippled in a motorcycle accident in 2012.
I'm very happy, at least I can move around now, not as when I'm stuck at home.
And we meet a woman that was beaten by a husband and then abandoned with the children.
I just told myself that I have to survive.
Our founding fathers
work to establish certain standards of governance. Some of their successors behave like spoiled children, breaking everything and bringing disorder to the house.
The leaders at that time, as well as those of us that followed them, were patriotic. They went into politics to serve, but not to be served.
It is people doing things wrong and not being sanctioned that led to this escalation.
What is going on now? We are beginning to lift up the quality of leadership.
We must not succumb to hopelessness and defeatism. We can fix our problems.
We have always lived together as brothers and sisters. Though we speak different languages and celebrate different cultures, we were still one Nigeria. There was no bombing, there was no kidnapping, and our children were not cultists. Now, we suspect one another as there are spreads of cultism, bombing, and kidnapping. How long shall this go on? Terrorism is alien, kidnapping is criminal, cultism is barbaric. Nigeria is a blessed country. Support the Nigeria Police and the fight against terrorism, kidnapping and cultism. Always inform the police of any incident around you. Say something when you suspect something.
Remember, we all have a stake in building a crime-free Nigeria of our dream.
This message is from the Nigeria Police Force.
Community policing in the face of growing security challenges is the focus on NTA Tuesday Live this week. Tuesday Live, informative, interactive, and engaging. Don't be told. Join us.
Fashanu trying a shot, and he's got in John Fashanu. John Fashanu's fifth goal of the season, and what a spectacular...
Great Nigerian people! Great Nigerian products! All made in Nigeria.
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 It's made in Nigeria. Tonight is made in Nigeria. Quality is guaranteed.
Nice, made in Nigerian good.
Made in Nigeria is where we are going now.
We're going to come to Made in Nigeria TV Expo and exhibition in April 2016. We're going to shell up for the Federal Capital Territory of Nigeria. Features include grand opening ceremony, live concert, and showcasing of many Ogbonge quality products from our expert manufacturers and states. 5 days of TV Expo and exhibition for Made in Nigeria products and services. For further inquiries, we're going to contact our contact platforms or visit any NTA station near you. Think international, because our products are going international.
Suicide bombers are not spirits. They are not ghosts. They are human beings like you and me. They live amongst us. They are your neighbors. They are your friends today, but terrorists tomorrow. So you must know your neighbor now. Security begins with you and me. Know your neighbor. Be vigilant. Be security conscious. Report suspicious persons, objects, and movements to the police and other security agencies. The security of our nation is a duty for you and me.
If you see something, say something. Nigeria, unite against terrorism.
This message is brought to you by the Federal Ministry of Information and Culture.
You're still on to NTA Nationwide. An automobile engineering product account for about 50% of total foreign technology consumed in Nigeria. Minister of Science and Technology, Dr. Bunai Onu, says this must be discouraged as the nation is currently working towards manufacture of local automobile products. Science correspondent Kieran Umeayo reports.
Bonayon noted that automotive technology is essential for the development of the nation. Therefore, local manufacture of automobile products through research must be encouraged.
We have the largest market in Africa, so there is no reason why our automobile industry cannot be strong. However, I still believe that if you look at what happened in the 1980s, 1990s, it is very clear to us that if our automobile industry had done research and developmental work for a period of time, it would have been strong enough even when government opened you up to competition from outside. Because, you know, most governments will not want to give the support of stopping competition from outside.
Managing Director of Peugeot Nigeria, Ibrahim Boyi, who called on the minister, said that there is need to grow indigenous technology for human capital development. In Abuja, Kirian Umayo, NTA News.
Kebbi State farmers interact with the state governor on wheat production. These are more from our Sokoto Network Center, where Fatih is standing by. Hello, Fatih.
Femi, you're welcome to Sokoto. The Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Abubakar Malemi, SAN, has charged alumni of Nigerian universities to be veritable partners in managing their alma maters, especially in funding and policy directions. He threw the challenge at the 40th anniversary lecture of the Usman Dafodio University, Sokoto, in a paper titled The Role of Alumni in 21st Century University. Usman Muhammad Binji completes the story.
The lecture was organized to commemorate the 40th anniversary of Usman Dafodio University, Sokoto. The Minister of Justice and Attorney General of the Federation, Abubakar Malami, SAN, dwell on the significance of alumni associations for the 21st century universities. He said alumni associations of Nigerian universities have a greater role to play in assisting students pursue their career and moving their alma mater to greater heights.
Most importantly, ladies and gentlemen, enhancing the quality of student life is important, and that we can do by ensuring students have the resources such as computer laboratories and library materials to facilitate the learning process.
At the convocation lecture, former Vice Chancellor Modibo Adama University Yola, Professor Salih Mustafa, focused on the role of Nigerian universities to national development, lamenting poor practical application of knowledge by Nigerian universities.
I emphasize the need for all Nigerian universities to entrench entrepreneurship, and not only entrepreneurship, but the principles of commercialization of knowledge, because that is the trend now worldwide.
He called on Nigerian universities to be producing job providers, not seekers. In Sokoto, Usman Muhammad Benji, NTA News.
Governor Abubakar Atiku Bagudu has stressed government's commitment to stamp out criminal activities in the state. Usman Abdullahi Shehu reports that Governor Bagudu reiterated this while inspecting hundreds of livestock recovered from rustlers by the Joint Task Force in Bena, Donko Osugu local government area of Kebbi State.
Over 1,600 animals that include cattle, goats, sheep, donkeys and camels were recovered in the Osogbo local government area of Kebbi State. Governor Abubakar Atiku Bagudu, while addressing security agents and members of the public in Bena town, described the recovery and arrest as a significant landmark in the fight against rustling and other criminal activities.
Using the occasion to help provide security to our people, and I'm glad that that cooperation, that resolve up today led to significant arrest, significant recoveries of animals.
Significant number of the recovered animals have been returned to their genuine owners through a committee set up by the state government to identify the owners of the stolen animals. Burning Kebbi, Suman Abdullahi Shehu, NTA News.
Have been asked to report any human rights violation to the National Human Rights Commission for proper action. This came to the fore at the launching of a nationwide sensitization campaign on human rights in Sokoto State by the Commission. Sheikh Muhammad Detti completes the story.
The National Human Rights Commission is a body saddled with the responsibility of protecting the rights of Nigerians from inhuman acts such as torture, extrajudicial killings, kidnapping, sexual harassment, as well as child labor. Executive Secretary, National Human Rights Commission, Professor B.M. Angwe said, the rights of every Nigerian is guaranteed under the 1999 Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. The commission, he said, will soon publish books on human rights in different Nigerian languages for the benefit of Nigeria.
But the most important task that we have today is to make Nigerians to be aware of their rights. When we empower Nigerians to know their rights, then they'll be able to rise up and to claim those rights.
Representative of the Senator Sokoto South Senatorial District, Abdullahi Abubakar Denje, appreciated the effort of National Human Rights Commission for making Nigerians aware of their rights. Stakeholder in the Human Rights and Donor Agencies Kabiru Umar Dodo said, to date, the office has received over 1,000 cases of human rights abuses and violations.
And we are still doing our best to ensure everybody knows his rights, regardless of sex, culture, and tradition.
The sensitization campaign had in attendance different youth groups in the state. In Sokoto, Shoaib Muhammad Eti, NTA News.
That's it from Sokoto. It's now back to Femi for the continuation of Nationwide. Good afternoon.
Thank you, Fatih. Have you ever been denied any opportunity just because of your race, ethnicity, religion, status, or any consideration that has little or nothing to do with the opportunity in question? Well, discrimination is a reality. And millions of people around the world are discriminated upon based on several factors that make development slow and promote mediocrity instead of excellence. Against this background of the International Day of the Elimination of Racial Discrimination, marked the 21st of March each year, Joy Uzo examines the issues surrounding racial discrimination. It's over to you, Joy.
Discrimination is an age-long and global phenomenon that has had significant effect on relations between people, groups, and sometimes nations. Why those who racially discriminate against others relish in it and try hard to justify it, those who suffer it feel cheated and do all in their power to resist it. Bottom line, the effects of racial discrimination are far-reaching and end up promoting bitterness, acrimony, friction and violence, which sometimes leads to war and economic sabotage, among others. This is why the United Nations came up with the Day Against Discrimination.
Just like ethnicism in Nigeria, where you overplay the issue of racism, you are creating room for bitterness, acrimony, like a little any other thing.
In those countries where it has been rife, there has been considerable progress.
Recent rhetorics by political aspirants in the upcoming presidential election of the United States have led to experts worrying about racism and discrimination.
U.S. is made up of different races and different colors and different backgrounds. So his word might be his own word for his own certain class, but I think the bigger picture will be a global world.
The theme for this year's celebration is Challenges and Achievements of the Durban Declaration and Program of Action 15 Years After. In Abuja, Joy Uzo, NTA News.
And from Abuja, we are going to Benin, where police inaugurate security control tower in Warri, just as NAFDAC raids shops in Asaba. Details of this and more from our Benin Network Center with Obehi as our guide. Hello, Obehi, it's over to you.
Hello, Femi. Thank you for joining us in Benin. The education prospect of the inmates of internally displaced persons camp in Benin has been scaled up following the donation of some education materials worth millions of naira to them. It is courtesy of the Nigerian Foundation for the Support of Victims of Terrorism Victim Support Fund. Elizabeth Owotoma reports.
Executive Director of Victim Support Fund, Professor Sunday Ochoche, said we ensure that the education of internally displaced persons is not truncated.
We have identified these victims here, these kids that are here, and among my many priorities is education. And especially for children, that is probably the number one thing they need after ensuring their environment, providing for food and their security.
Wife of Edo State Governor, Mrs. Yara Oshomole, said the items will enhance the state of education at the camp.
We are so happy, wonderful group of people that really care to have all these people around us.
Children and caregivers of the camp thanked the organization for the gesture.
I think they really appreciate them for what they brought, and we need food, we need food stuff.
I want to thank the people that bring this property for us. I want to tell them God bless them.
Challenge here is one, occasional item. Two, food. Once the children eat, they're happy. They don't trouble anyone. So now, these are the best children I've ever seen. In.
With these educational materials provided for the internally displaced persons here at Uwagwa, it is a sure way to reducing the problems of education. Elizabeth Owotoma, NTN News.
It has been observed that for Nigeria to achieve the expected result in technical and vocational education, proactive measures by critical stakeholders are essential. This is part of submissions by stakeholders in education at a stakeholders forum facilitated by the National Board for Technical Education in Ekiti. Kola Adebubuye reports.
The forum observed with great concern a growing apathy to the practice of agriculture as a career in Nigeria because of sole dependence on oil and its derivatives, with the need to redesign and re-engineer educational curricula to fit the needs of today's technological institutions, which are best to drive agriculture in the country.
To see that quality is maintained in the level of training, that is through our accreditation exercise, through the development of new innovations and imputing them into our curricula.
I do understand from MBTE that they are very supportive of upgrading curriculum.
Participants described the workshop as timely, based on suggestions aimed at strengthening and establishing entrepreneurship development and vocational studies.
All of us can take a look at our current curricula that will enable us to achieve the desired results.
To train the trainer on how best we can practice agriculture as it is done in advanced countries.
The workshop tagged Decision Makers Leadership. Participants are optimistic we go a long way in bringing about necessary change that will help enhance a rebirth of the values of the past, which made Nigeria a significant player in the global economic league. In Ado Ekiti, Kola Adebubuye, NTN News.
That's our package, Femi. It's back to you for the rest of Nationwide News.
Thank you, Behi. President Muhammadu Buhari has condemned the terrorist attack in Brussels. In a statement by the special advisor to the president of media and publicity, Femi Adesina, the president commiserated with the prime minister Charles Michel and Belgians over the loss of more than 30 lives in the attack. He says the attack reinforces the need for greater international cooperation to effectively confront and destroy terrorism and its perpetrators. President Buhari assured the global communities of Nigeria's support for the fight against terrorism and wishes the more than 100 injured persons in the attack speedy recovery. And on Global Tidbits, Islamic State claimed responsibility for another terror attack at Brussels International Airport and a metro station in the Belgian capital, in which at least 31 people were killed and 81 injured. Also, international observers call for calm as electorates await results of the rerun of presidential election in Niger. For more Global Tidbits, it's time now to join Ronke Kolawole.
Following a new outbreak of Ebola in Guinea, Liberia has closed part of its border with the country and said the situation remains until further notice. So far, 4 people have been killed in the fresh Ebola outbreak, while 800 have been quarantined. The last is yet to be heard about the missing Malaysian airline MH370, as efforts have been made to lead a team of investigators to South Africa to verify if a piece of debris found in the country belongs to the missing Malaysian plane. In Cuba, argument broke out between the president, Raul Castro, and President Barack Obama over human rights issues, particularly the American prison at Guantanamo Bay and Cuba's political prisoners. And now, it appears that San Suu Kyi, the leader of NLD, the party that won the historic presidential election in Myanmar, may be the only woman appointed to the cabinet. Her name appeared on the list submitted to the parliament. For Global Tidbits, Ronke Kolawole, NTN News.
And the sports now, the arrival of 19 foreign-based players excite football fans as Super Eagles had their full house training in Abuja on Tuesday morning before travelling to Kaduna ahead of Friday's clash with the Pharaohs of Egypt. Amanze Marcos was at the training pitch. This is what he brought back.
This is the Abuja National Stadium where 19 Super Eagles players are training ahead of the AFCON 2017 doubleheader against the Pharaohs of Egypt in Kaduna on the 25th of March and in Alexandria, Egypt on the 29th of March. Of the 21 foreign-based professionals, two defenders, Leo Balogun and Kenneth Omeru, are out, leaving 19 plus the six home-based professionals. The list has three goalkeepers led by Kari Keme, eight defenders, five midfielders with John Mikel Obi included, and nine strikers led by Captain Ahmed Musa.
I'm happy that these guys are, you know, they're happy they're coming back to play for the country. And trust me, I think this is the youngest team we've ever had before in Super Eagles. These guys will come out and play for us and make sure Nigerians will be very happy for a very long period of time.
Please and please, they should just keep on supporting us. We're going to make them proud. They'll just come out and put us in prayer by the grace of God. We'll make them proud once more.
Alex Iwobi of Arsenal and Fernando Adi of Portland Timbers in the MLS are expected to be capped for Nigeria.
I woke up to the great news and I'm excited to be here and I can't wait to be on the field. You know, we're training today, we're trying to do our best with a heat, but you know, it's what we've decided to do for the nation.
Alex's father is glad his son will play for Nigeria, despite pressure from the English FA for Alex Iwobi to play for the Three Lions of England, having featured for the England youth team.
I played football when I was younger, but I never had the opportunity to play for Nigeria. He has been given the opportunity and I'm hoping that he will take it with both hands.
A large turnout of fans witnessed the team's last training session at the Abuja National Stadium, hailing the Samson Siasia boys to give their best in the two-legged encounter and qualify for AFCON 2017 in Gabon. With sports news update, Amanze Marcus, NTA News.
And that's it on NTA Nationwide. We thank you for joining us. My name is Femi Johnson. Do join us for more reports that will be coming your way at 6 o'clock. Also, the 7 o'clock news. And don't forget, too, that the 9 o'clock network news will be on. Good afternoon.